I think, yeah, your first came through at university, so I studied sports psychology from undergrad and master's level. And although I recognised how powerful it can be in terms of performance, I was a lot more interested in the holistic development and more welfare side of athletes. Working closely with the John Moore Scholars, the athletes there, I realised just what a powerful tool it can be when it's used effectively and how it can positively impact not only their athletic performance but also the wider development. So that's where I've seen the value, and I thought that's something that I'd like to contribute towards. I think it's quite an indirect impact, really, and I think it's one that may not be seen straight away. So maybe something that an athlete may reflect upon, whether they're going through a quite a tough time, whether people do studies, family issues. I think performance lifestyle can have a long-term effect on not only an athlete's career, but their life. Obviously, as a discipline, we try and give them the tools and techniques and skills to go on to develop the career, potentially outside the sport, but also within the sport. Now, in terms of how that affects performance, in my opinion, anything as a performance lifestyle advisor, anything that I can do to almost reduce stress and reduce the noise around the sport gives them more capacity to then focus on training, competitions, performance. That's kind of where I see my role, is if I'm able to take a little bit of stress away from them, they're able to then give a little bit more in training, which has a knock-on effect on performance. Determination, really. Like the interview process can be difficult. So the first PL job I went for, I got rejected for, which at the time I was gutted about it, to be honest. You're never gonna, it's uncommon that you're gonna get the very first job you go for and you're gonna see that through until you retire. If you do, brilliant. But generally that's not how it goes. I think especially with PL, you've got to find the sport that fits you. Because you could be a fantastic practitioner. You don't fit the sport, and you don't understand the challenges that sport and the culture faces, your message can get lost. Just to be able to say that you're a part of somebody's journey, so like I'm confident in saying that we've got gold medal winners in the gym now, and just to be able to say I've positively impacted their journey or made it that little bit more enjoyable. That's a really, really good feeling. But also going on from that, being able to equip them, as I was saying before, with the skills and the tools necessary to then flourish after competitive boxing, whether that be within business, coaching, commentary, media. If I'm able to give them tools and qualifications to come into a career there, then that's what I'm proud to say, that I work on the programme.